In this lecture, we will see the properties of second and sixth compound semiconductors. And as we know, and also suggested by this formula, these compounds are formed by combining of group second elements and group six elements of the periodic table. So let me first make a combination of all these second and sixth elements. So I am writing here group second B elements, and here I am writing group six elements in this. So first one is Zn, then cadmium Cd, then mercury Hg, and here the first one is oxygen, then sulfur, then Sc selenium and Te tellurium. So we can make a combination of this Zn now, then CdO, HgO. Similarly, we can make combination ZnS, CdS, HgS, then ZnSe, CdSe and HgSe, and then ZnTe, CdTe and HgTe. Among these oxides, this ZnO is very important. And ZnO has found many applications in various fields, but very little information is available about these two oxides, that is CdO and HgO. And all these remaining compounds are known as chalcogenides. All these nine compounds are known as chalcogenides. And among these, note all of these are semiconductors. These two HGSE and HGTE are semi-metal. You may be surprised to know the difference between semiconductor and semi-metals, but there is a difference between these two. So these two, HGSE and HGTE, are semi-metals, and HGS is also a semiconductor. And remaining these six compounds are very important. Most of the time, 2-6 compounds mean these six compound semiconductors. So these compound semiconductors are very important. Most of these have wide band gap, and their band gap is a direct band gap. Now we can look their structure. The crystal structure of these compounds is rather complex. It's not as simple as in the case of 3 and 5 semiconductor. Most of these compounds crystallize in the zinc blend and Woodside structure. Normally, at room temperature, these compounds are found in zinc blend structure while at higher temperature, these are in woodside structure. One interesting property of these second six compounds is that at atmospheric pressure, they undergo a solid phase transition. Below the melting point, these phase transition materials are finding many applications in cooling system. Normally, CDS and CDSC crystallize in the HCP woodside structure. ZN TE and CDTE in zinc blend structure. Whereas ZNS and ZNSE can exist in both of these structures. That is ZnS and ZnSc can be found in both of these structures. That is ZnS and ZnSe may be either in zinc blend structure or in Wurzite structure. Now let me discuss about their bonding. The bonding in these compounds is a mixture of covalent and ionic type. This is due to the fact that average number of electrons per atom is still 4, as found in the case of elemental or 3-5 semiconductors. Since group 6 atoms are more electronegative, then group 2nd atoms or elements we can see ionicity in these compounds, and in the lecture when I was discussing about the properties of 3 and 5 semiconductors, I discussed the reason about this ionic vector in this type of semiconductors. This ionic vector varies considerably over the whole range and increases as the atomic size decreases. Therefore, ZnS is predominantly ionic, while the bonding in HgTe is nearly covalent in nature. As we know that as we go in a periodic table in this direction, the atomic size will decrease, and as we go in this direction, atomic size will increase. So by applying this same formula, since ionic character in this compound increases with increase in the with decrease in the atomic size, so therefore the atomic size over the ionic character in ZnS is maximum as compared to other compounds. Again, as we know that the ionic character has the effect of binding the valence electrons rather tightly to the lattice atom. Therefore, these compounds have wider band gap. As compared to the semiconductors, of covalent bonding. And due to their wide band gap, wide and also direct band gap, these materials are considered potential source of electroluminescent devices, just like LEDs. Now let me discuss about their formula. Second six compounds are not only found in binary form but also in ternary form like A belongs to group second, B that belongs to group six, and C that also belongs to 6. So if this is X, then this must be 1 minus X. Where X ranges from 0 to 1. So therefore, a crystal like ZMS and SE type is also possible. And it is worth to note that the properties of these compounds vary gradually with the fraction of X. Now let me discuss about their type of conductivity. Some of the second six compounds have n-type conductivity. others have p-type conductivity. And another set can have both types of conductivity. That is, they can be p-type or n-type. Like ZnO, CdS, CdSc, and ZnS are of n type, binary, second, six compound semiconductors. It is also to note that the production of n-type ZnS is very difficult. As compared to others, ZnTe can be easily grown with p-type conductivity. While CdTe and ZnSe can be easily produced in both types of conductivity. The production of p-type CdTe is not easy. While the production of n-type CdTe is very easy. production of N-type ZnHc is also very difficult. And as we know that all these second six compound semiconductors have direct and wide band gaps, therefore therefore these materials can be used in very efficient light emitting diodes, and it is because their wide band gap can cover a whole range of visible spectrum or visible light. So they can absorb light from infrared to UV in range, ultraviolet in range. These compound semiconductors are very useful in efficient light emitting diodes, because due to their wider band gap, they can absorb whole portion of the visible light. These are some major application of these compound semiconductors. There are other compound semiconductors also that belong to 4th and 6th group. These semiconductors are known as narrow band gap semiconductors, and they have some application in infrared detectors and lasers. You can study these compound semiconductors if you want, but these are not in our syllabus. There are some other semiconductors also, like MgO, Cu2O, TiO2, U2O3, Fe2O3. Some of these compounds have found use in devices such as thermistors, but many others are only for academic interest. So if you want to study these remaining semiconductors, you can study. But in our syllabus, we have only elemental semiconductors, 3-5 semiconductors, and 2-6 compound semiconductors.